Okay, so we're gonna go through a 360 degree view of the neighborhood first. As you can see, this is the gravel road that leads to the house. And then you have a cement slab leading to the garage. The three-car garage. And an extra covered area, which I think could be easily turned into a garage as well. A little deeper than the garage itself. This is the backyard view. Pretty much no neighbors in the view. There's a few cracks that were repaired on the stucco. Nothing alarming, you know, from the first view. This is an in-ground self-cleaning pool, which is an upgrade from building a pool with the pop-ups to clean the bottom of the pool. No high-powered lines here. Looks like there was a couple repairs done on this stucco wall and surface cracks, probably before it was painted. So this is the fourth bedroom or an office that I was describing, which is about 15 by 9. It does have a closet. Nice high ceilings. And right next to it, you have the guest bathroom. The master bedroom is a nice size. It starts off a little narrow and then it expands out into a full bedroom. You have windows on this side, and here. And you have a nice door that leads out into the backyard as well. This looks like a gas or propane fireplace. Nice high ceilings, probably, I have to guess, 9-foot ceilings. And in the master bathroom, you have 10-foot ceilings. This is cultured stone, very basic setup, plastic type. An extra linen area. Decent sized closet. So this is the entryway, and then we're going into the split floor plan of the other two bedrooms. I'll measure out each room so you have an idea of what everything looks like. They obviously love horses. So then you have the Jack and Jill bathroom that connects the two bedrooms together. One sink and a linen closet. Also the cultured stone finish in the bathroom with the tub. And bedroom number 4. This one is a walk-in closet. I'm sure there's a light here somewhere. There is, but I didn't locate it just yet. Normal to see some surface cracks in the ceiling of the garage. Just about every garage I see it in just needs to be patched up. There's a small crack here. And I noticed another crack here. Nothing alarming unless the home inspector says it is. They usually say if you can fit a quarter inside the crack, then it's an alarming concern. Other than that, I didn't see any other surface cracks in the foundation. There's another fireplace that's connected to what it looks like, a propane tank. And this is another exit to the backyard. This feels like it's 11 feet tall. It is a sunken room, so you have a couple steps up. It feels very spacious and big. Looks like they had this house painted recently, and they usually fix all the cracks by caulking them, and it never matches perfectly. This looks like the setup for the sun power equipment, the inverter, Arim HVAC, propane tanks. It looks like a newer furnace. This is another connection for the sun power for the solar system. And pool equipment looks